So you've retired.
Oh, yeah. Almost exactly 8 years ago, actually. My last scene was end of April in 2011.
So why did you retire?
That's the question that everybody wants to know. And my usual answer is, you have to read my book that's going to come out to find out. But there's a myriad of reasons. There's like a zillion reasons. Piracy is one of them. Mm. Because of Tube Sites, it wasn't financially doable for me to keep producing. And seeing my hard work like out there for free was heartbreaking, just awful. So the piracy had a lot to do with it. Mm-hmm. I also felt that a lot of the industry was going in a direction that I wasn't quite into. I saw a lot of girls doing a lot of things on the side, escorting privates, those kinds of things, mm-hmm. and, you know, agencies possibly being involved with that stuff. And and I was just like, I don't want to be a part of this. This isn't what I signed up for. Granted, I don't think there's anything wrong with any kind of sex work. I think to each your own. But I do remember, I believe it was like bringing in STDs possibly, like that kind of stuff. It just made me feel a little unsafe, you know. And I also, the industry started to get really huge.
Yeah.
Like really huge. When I was, you know, when I started, we used to go to a place called AIM to get tested back in 2001.
Good old AIM.
And there was like, I think they said that there was like, you know, I don't know, like a few hundred people or something that got tested at that time, you know, there for the industry. And now there's like thousands and thousands and thousands and thousands and thousands, you know, there wasn't even like adult made movies really made in other areas. It was predominantly just here, but now it's like you have Vegas and you have Miami and you have so much more in Europe. And, you know, I feel like there's just so much more going on. The industry stopped being as close-knit as I liked it to be, because it felt more like a family where you knew everybody. And it just started to get so much bigger and bigger and bigger. And I was just like, I don't know any of these people anymore. So it started to make me feel a little unsafe. And I don't know, other reasons too. A lot of other reasons.
People will have to read your book to find out.
Yeah, yeah.
Do you have any idea when your book is coming out? Or are you still working on it?
Oh, I'm still. The problem is that other projects keep coming up.
I hear you.
And it's really hard to write about yourself in your own life.
Yeah.
Like, harder than I expected it to be.
Yeah.
So I've been working on two different books, a creative writing project and my memoir. Mm-hmm. And the memoir just keeps getting pushed back further and further because I'm having the hardest time talking about myself.
Do you almost feel like it's kind of narcissistic to be writing a book?
It's incredibly narcissistic.
Yourself? Yeah, I hear you.
And because I'm studying psychology, I'm like, why am I doing this? What's the motivation behind me doing this? And mostly it's because fans want to know, you know, they're interested. And of course, it'll hopefully make me some money, but it's you know, getting my story out there is the purpose in it. But at the same time, it kind of makes me feel like, God, I'm just talking about myself over and over. And that's why I don't really like interviews either. I just keep talking about myself.
That's funny because that is so unlike, you know, so many people that are generally in front of the camera. Usually, like, they love talking about themselves.
The way I used to be too. I used to be more like that too. But I think now that I'm...
You think now that you have like some distance from the industry, you're kind of like...
Well, I'm not inside the porn bubble anymore.
Right.
Because it really is a bubble. Yeah. And once you step outside, you realize, oh my God, like the world, there's a whole huge world out there.
That doesn't revolve around you.
That also just doesn't revolve around porn.
Yeah.
You know, and who's doing what in porn and everything like that. So it's,
it's definitely very insular. Did you encounter any stigma at all, like when you left the industry?
I mean, there's always going to be stigma, I think. And I think that's one of the problems. Oh, I can't wait for you to hear my TED Talk.
You're going to get to that.
Sorry.
I know.
You keep asking me things that I kind of touch upon in it.
Right,
so I'm like, but I'm sorry. Go back. What was...
If you've ever encountered like any stigma after you left the industry, like was there anything that you tried to achieve or tried to do that you got roadblocks because of what you used to do?
I mean, I just had one recently, actually. I just released a book, a 84-page photography book, all shot on film, commemorating my final dance tour. Mm-hmm. And when we had the event, we actually had a problem where we could not get a liquor sponsor because it was adult-related. The people pulled out at the very last minute.
Interesting.
Because they found out it was adult related. And I was like, are you kidding me? Like, you're an alcohol company.
I know. Seriously.
like I would get if it was like a church.
I mean, I think we can safely say that liquor has caused more damage and deaths than porn has.
Absolutely.
And as a, you know, as an ex-alcoholic.
I keep forgetting I'm on camera. So
as an ex-alcoholic, I can absolutely say that.
Yes. It has. Alcohol is terrible. Why do you think I smoke so much weed? Alcohol is terrible.
I mean, if you can, you know, manage it. I mean, look, anything that you can do responsibly is fine. I don't have anything personal against alcohol. I just can't consume it. But I don't think like it should people I mean, should I, drink it. But.
No, I enjoy my champagne and my wine here and there.
Yeah,
totally.
I wish I could.
I just prefer herbal stuff.
I can't do that either.
I'm so sorry.
It's okay. It's all right. It's okay. I just eat pies in the bath.
Oh, that's see, what... I'm with you on that. We can do that together. You can just get a huge tub of ice cream and just.
That sounds really. That sounds like a porn scene.
We can just actually eat. Does.
You're like, oh, that's great. I like eating pie in the bath. We can do that together. We can eat pie in the bath together.
See,
Jenna, are you sure you don't want to come back?
There is a little porn still left in me, damn it. No, but that's the thing. And I think that's a big thing coming out of it. People have given me crap because I keep posting sexy pictures or I keep doing nude photography shoots. And people are like, why, if you're out of porn, why are you still promoting your fleshlight? Why are you still doing this? And I'm like, because I'm still a sexy woman.
Yeah.
And I still love my sexuality. I don't regret anything that I did. So why should I, just because I retired, why should I shun it?
Yeah. It seems like it's got to be like so black and white. It's either got to be you're in the porn industry and you're performing and you're all for it. Or if you've left the porn industry, you left because like you hate it and you regret everything that you did. And you have all this trauma and you don't want anything to do with it anymore. Like,
and
I think
it's not
people,
like that.
Right.
And for me, at least.
No, it's, I mean, you know, that's been the case with some people, obviously, but it's not the case for everybody. I mean, there's, I mean, here's a perfect example. Look at Sunny Leone, right? Mm-hmm. Like, she's a huge Bollywood star now.
Massive.
Like, fucking massive.
She's probably the most famous person I've ever had sex with.
Yeah. I mean, she's huge. So, but she doesn't. Like, she doesn't do porn anymore, obviously. Mm-hmm. She's got, like, a mainstream acting career. She's got a very successful career in India. But she doesn't, like, regret having done porn. She doesn't turn around and say, like, that's the worst. I wish I'd never done it. You know? Like, she just found something else that worked for her, and she moved on. And
totally.
It's not easy, especially being in front of the camera. It's not easy to be in porn your whole fucking life. Now, some people can do it. Like, some people can have serious longevity in it. But I don't know anyone that, like, you know, has been in the industry for a long time who hasn't at least like taken a break for a while.
Right, right.
You know, because it's a lot on your body.
It is. And I don't, you know, I don't regret anything that I did, really.
Yeah.
I enjoyed my career and everything. And I think that you're right. Like, people think it has to be black or white. Mm-hmm. And it's not. Like, life is gray. Mm-hmm. Most of life is gray. It's not black or white.
Yes.
And I, you know, I like being naked on camera still in photo shoots. And I still like to portray my sexuality, you know. Someday I'm going to be old and wrinkled and I'm not going to be able to do these kinds of things.
Right.
So right now, yeah, I'm still going to be showing my body off if I want to. It's my prerogative.
Yeah, absolutely.
You know, and I like it. I like being sexy. I've always been a sexual person, even before I got into adults. So why should I have to just flip a switch and turn that off just because I'm now a student and I'm going to be a psychologist? Like...
Yeah, I think people really like, especially when it comes to sexuality, people really want to pigeonhole you and they really want to characterize you as being one thing or the other, you know, like people aren't comfortable. It's like people aren't comfortable with a woman being sexual and a woman being intelligent and a woman like working in a professional environment, like what you're working towards. It's like you have to be like one or the other, you know, if you're sexy and you're naked, you can't be intelligent and you can't be educated, you know, it's like people's brains just explode with the idea that a woman could be more than one thing.
I know. And I feel like I got that. A lot of people, when I was in the industry, a lot of people think that I'm not very intelligent because I smoke pot and I'm in porn and I have this like bubbly, you know, kind of goofy laugh and everything like that. And I remember reading some comments people would write being like, oh, I bet she's so stupid. I bet she's so stupid. You know? And so like, that was actually one of the things, like when I went back to school, I was like, oh, I kind of get to prove it to people now that I've got more going on, you know, behind this body and this face than just, you know, sexuality.
Thank you so much for watching. If you enjoyed the show, make sure that you subscribe so you don't miss a single episode. And go check out all the other videos. I film every single one of my podcasts. And if you want to listen to the audio version, I'm on iTunes and all the other podcast platforms. Visit hollyrandallunfiltered.com to find out more.